Hi everyone, I'm Dimitris, the project manager for Goguen, and I'm here with Volodymyr, the project manager for the Cardano node.
Hello everyone.
Welcome to another video in our series of new development updates, charting the progress of the Goguen rollout. As mentioned in the previous video, every 2 weeks we'll be bringing you the latest updates on Cardano development as we continue to roll out new Goguen features and functionalities. Every fortnight, we finish a fresh development sprint, so expect to hear a lot more from us in the coming weeks and months. And this update is a big one, isn't it, Volodymyr? Because it has been a very busy 2 weeks.
Yes, very busy. Goguen is a complex project, and there is a lot going, but all of it aimed at bringing exciting new functionality and opening up new use cases for Cardano with each protocol update on the mainnet. There are lots of different teams all contributing to the Goguen rollout and its ongoing development. In these updates, we give you a bird's eye view on all the work that is going on, as well as zooming in to specific areas of interest.
So every 2 weeks, we complete a new sprint. So we are going to start with an overview of the latest progress on the node and the smart contract sites over this time period. We'll also look ahead to the next sprint and a little beyond, covering highlights of what activities you can expect coming in the next few weeks in the area of, for example, token locking, native tokens, smart contracts, and all the other elements of the Goguen rollout.
The node teams continue on delivering native token and token locking features. These past 2 weeks, the teams have focused on adding enhancements, tests, and node API and CLI implementations. The Ledger team has finalized the native token and token locking CDDL specification, which is a description language for the on-disk formats we use. Actually, this specification is used by any downstream team which needs to interact with the blockchain, like the wallet teams, or basically anyone building third-party utilities. Also, the Ledger team enhanced the native token functionality with an optional script feature, which allows users to include the script in this transaction, such that the recipient wallet could spot the fact that this sender can spend from this address. The previous 2 weeks, the consensus team has been focusing on testing native tokens and token locking extensively. We added what we call golden tests, which check if the serialization format is not broken. Golden tests protect us against that. In addition, the team added the test that allows us to ensure that protocol updates will go as planned. Actually, it creates various fake networks with multiple nodes joining at the different times and transactions that trigger protocol updates, so the team can observe systems behavior afterwards. And the Node API and CLI team completed the main part of expanding Node API to token locking and native tokens. Also, the team has basic CLI syntax implemented, which is a structure of native token commands used by users.
So on native tokens pre-production environment, we are now close to opening up the pre-production environment that will allow the creation, distribution, and forging of native tokens in Cardano. In particular, the team key activities that we're looking to complete in the near term is the native token node CLI pre-production environment setup and updating the related documentation, producing a set of exercises for token creation via the node CLI, and implement the wallet backend changes required to produce a version that allows using the existing wallets without any impact from the multi-asset changes to be introduced. This native token functionality will be launched in waves. We'll start from the node CLI and involve to include the working wallet, explorer support, as well as the means for registering new tokens via the metadata repo. There is a good development progress, so please make sure you keep an eye on communication updates over the coming weeks if you are interested in creating your own tokens via the command line. ERC20 Converter is a tool that allows users to manage their tokens on Cardano chain. One of the key functionalities that the tool allows is the migration of tokens from other blockchains. This is on track to be released for testing the functionality on the native tokens node CLI pre-production environment shortly after the environment becomes available. For more details, which are to be shared in next videos, please look out for this video series. On the Pluto side, we now have two teams, the first one working on the Plutus core features, and then we have the Plutus application team that aims to improve your experience by introducing improvements to the playground, as well as delivering the Plutus application framework. Starting from the Plutus core front, we have been working on finalizing the cost model by calculating the CEK machine memory usage and producing a first version of the related documentation for developers. We are producing an explanation document for the ledger model. We are writing a language-independent specification describing the fiat encoding. And also, we're working on improvements on the evaluator performance by profiling the execution of complex programs to identify performance bottlenecks using the Brun indices in the CEK and trying out the hostile interpreter. Furthermore, on the Plutus apps, the Plutus Playground refers remains our next target when it comes to Plutus apps. The development is ongoing for this on an emulated version of Cardano, and we are now working to implement the UX and UI changes already designed, as well as prepare more sample contracts and in general restyling the playground. Last but not least, we're also working on improving the emulator, including performance and usability. Marlowe-wise, following the recent Marlowe Alpha release, the next release scope, beta, is now almost finalized, and we are also planning the next one in line, which will be Marlowe 1.0, that is aimed to be in parallel with the Plutus application framework launch in due time. Further UI changes on implementing the Marlowe Playground are also underway, giving a uniform visual design to the system. The team is also working on the static analysis to implement further use of Isabel proofs in support of the implementation, as well as stepping back to make a survey of other contract properties that can be guaranteed by static analysis and are to be included in version one. Actus work also progresses with the inline Java wrapper for the test kit, the implementation of the quick check generators, and filtering zero contracts and more. On the DevTool side, the team has been working, aiming to complete the foreign export for Haskell to JavaScript compiler, working on improving and documenting our Next-based Haskell build infrastructure, and working on smoothing out any upgrade wibbles that Haskell developers might experience on macOS Big Sur.
Now, we'll give you a little bit of a look ahead what development activities are coming across the next weeks. On the node side, the Ledger team is working on running our full shellac test suite against native token and token locking features. Also, our development teams are actively expanding the development test suite with various tests like unit, performance, property tests to validate new features from different angles. We are working on running protocol update simulators to observe the system's behavior going through a set of protocol updates. We continue implementing Cardano API and CLI for native token and token locking, and also working on preparing a new node for quality assurance testing.
So what comes next on the Plutus? Starting from core, we're aiming to start writing up the design of the cost model, work on adding extra byte sync built-ins to Plutus Core, and experiment with an alternative evaluator design which might improve performance. From an application perspective, over the next few weeks, we will continue with the UI changes for the playground refresh, improve the emulator and state machine libraries, and start working on a new sample contract and documentation in relation to that. For Marlowe, the work included in the sprint we aim to start next in early December focuses on working with the playground to disengage the Marlowe editor from the simulator pane and to begin working on how to present the stage of the contract in the simulator using blockly rather than text. To begin work also on the infrastructure that will support the securitization of contracts where multiple tokens control a particular role in a running contract. And we're also looking to implement the investment preservation proof for Actus and also using the Haskell version of the Marlowe interpreter in the playground. On the DevTool side, we will work over the next few weeks on integrating the Haskell to JavaScript compiler into GHC, investigate if Thea IDE can be made to work with our Plutus Dev container for a cloud-based development environment, for example, via Gitpod.io, and last but not least, integrate extensible interface files with our Plutus compiler.
That's the update for this time. We hope that was informative for you. Any questions, any comments, please send them. And also any feedback on the video, we'll be happy to hear it. Have a great day and speak to you all very soon.